What's going on, guys, and welcome to the InfoWave. So another week, another Nvidia talk. And look, guys, I'm not a Nvidia hater or a Nvidia fanboy by any means. I'm just a tech enthusiast who loves to use the technology. And quite honestly, I have used multiple Nvidia cards from the multiple generation, and I really love to use them because I love the fact that usually Nvidia cards perform better than AMD counterparts. So I really love Nvidia technology, and therefore I have used Nvidia cards. But today we are going to discuss about failing situation of RTX 2080 Ti. So let's get this started. So newer generation product launches rarely go smooth, and that's applicable for all industries. And it is acceptable to be having a little bit manufacturing defect, or the product is working with a little bit malfunctioning for the newer generation product. But it's no way acceptable for the product which cost up to $1,200 and rendering completely useless. And that's exactly happening with Nvidia's RTX 2080 Ti, which is their flagship product. There have been multiple posts on Reddit, Facebook, Twitter, and even on Nvidia's own forum. The RTX 2080 Ti users are complaining about crashes, artifacts, or even card is completely dying off, rendering it as a useless. And noteworthy thing here is even the replacement card are showing same situation. Replacement cards also dying off, having crashes and artifacts. So replacements also isn't doing any favor to RTX 2080 Ti users. Problem apparently don't limited to the Founders Edition of RTX 2080 Ti cards. Even add-on partners cards are showing similar kinds of issue. This could indicating towards the deep problem inside the Turing architecture itself, or it could be manufacturing defect inside the GPU where add-on partners produce their GPUs inside their manufacturing plants. What's exactly wrong with RTX 2080 Ti? Well, apparently this new Turing generation of graphic cards uses new GDDR6 memory produced by the Microns. And it's been observed that these memory modules get overheat during extended period of time. Like if you put 100% load on these memories, like when you are playing some memory hungry game or synthetic benchmark, and if it happens that memory is continuously running at 100% load, these memories do get pretty hot pretty quickly. So that's the issue, that these new RTX 2080 Ti cards are crashing. At least for most of people, this memory overheating issue is the root cause that RTX 2080 Ti card is failing for most of user at least. So there seems to be something wrong with the manufacturing of this memories, or the way Nvidia have implemented this GDDR6 memories on their graphic cards. The design could be, I think there is some design defect regarding the placement of this memory modules. The memory modules should be directly sitting behind some heat sink, or the separate heat sink should be made to cool down this memory modules from the Micron, so as not to overheat pretty quickly. But they haven't done that, and this is the first generation product. And also these Micron memories are first generation GDDR6 memories produced exclusively for this new Turing based architecture. So that's why there could be some points regarding the R&D that could be missed by Nvidia or even Micron, that they couldn't touchdown, and that's why these memory modules from Microns are getting overheat and causing the RTX 2080 Ti to have artifacts and crashes and various issues with mass numbers of users. This new GDDR6 memory modules from Microns runs at about 7 Gbps on RTX 2080 Ti. Now, several users from the Reddit have posted that they have lowered the memory speed at about 50 megahertz from the stock 7 Gbps speed, and the issue is completely resolved. So as I said before, Micron and Nvidia might haven't got enough time to do R&D on these newer memories because they could be having a tight deadline to launch these new RTX graphic cards, and therefore they might haven't done proper R&D on the speed of this new memory modules, and they have set stock speed of 7 Gbps, but 7 Gbps is not at optimum value as the card is getting failed again and again. And therefore I think Nvidia or Micron haven't done proper R&D over this new GDDR6 memory module, and they haven't done proper testing to run these memories on the proper optimum speed to give, you know, sustained kind of performance rather than, you know, stuttering and doing artifacts and completely crashing of the RTX 2080 Ti card. Nvidia's response to this is like, as usual, they are handling this situation as usual business, and they are saying that this is not mass spread issues among the RTX 2080 Ti users. There are just fewer people as always who are having some random problems and random issues, and they are just talking with individual users who were having this problem with RTX 2080 Ti graphic cards. But we know that this is not some random problem. The most of people who have brought RTX 2080 Ti happen to have suffering from various crashes, artifacts, and completely failure of this RTX 2080 Ti cards. So therefore Nvidia's nominal response to this is showing that they are very ignorant regarding their customers, and they don't care much about their customers, even though they are purchasing $1,200 of flagship graphic cards. So in my opinion, this is very poorly handled response from the Nvidia to their customers. It's like people or user who have purchased this new RTX 2080 Ti cards are like, you know, beta testers who have paid $1,200 just to be beta testers of this new RTX 2080 Ti graphic cards, and now they are facing various kinds of problem, and they are feeling headache because of the failures of this new RTX 2080 Ti graphic cards. So whenever a product comes which is in its first generation phase, you should definitely consider at least 2 to 3 times before purchasing that product. Let other tech publisher test that product thoroughly, and after that only you should consider to spend that much amount of money to spend on some flagship kinds of product or any product which is in its first generation phase, like this new RTX graphic cards which promise to do real-time ray tracing. These cards are in its first generation phase, so therefore in my opinion, if it's any newer technological product which is in its first generation phase, you should definitely consider twice or thrice before purchasing the first generation product. So let me know guys what you think about this failing of RTX 2080 Ti cards, because matter of fact is, you know, RTX function of this new RTX 2080 Ti or every RTX graphic card haven't been tapped out yet, and this flagship RTX 2080 Ti is failing at the moment. So let me know guys what you think via comment section, and I will definitely love to check it out. And yeah, subscribe to this channel if you haven't already, because this channel is all about the information and technological stuff from all over the internet. And I will love to see you guys in the next video. Till then, bye bye.